battle is not yours. Don't own it. Don't accept it. You got this. Welcome to Unity Fellowship Church of Columbia, where love is in action. We're so glad that you were able to join us today, fellowship with us today, rejoice today. It's a wonderful day because we're all alive. And I thank you for being here. Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
We praise you, Yahweh, in your sanctuary. We praise you in your mighty sky. We praise you for your powerful deeds. We praise you for your overwhelming glory. We praise you with the blast of the trumpet. We praise you with lyre and harp. We praise you with tremble and dance. We praise you with strings and flute. We praise you with clashing cymbals.
Yes, yes.
We praise you with resounding cymbals. Let everything that has breath praise Yahweh.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
We will now have our opening prayer by Deacon Renee Weaver.
Praise the Lord, family. Praise the Lord, family. It's good to be back in the house of the Lord. Praise God, praise God. I'm Deacon Renee Weaver. I'm here to do the opening prayer. I ask that if all hearts and minds are clear this morning, that you would go to your prayer posture as we ask God to bless this day, the rest of this service, and the rest of this week. Creator God, we thank you for all things, dear Lord. We thank you for the breath in our lungs. We thank you for the activity in our limbs. We thank you, oh God, for giving us another opportunity to come into the house of prayer and your house of worship. Creator God, we thank you, oh God, just because you have been so good to us, oh God. Many of us you have caused to rise up off of our sickbed, oh God. Many of us, oh God, you have stayed the hand of death. Many of us, oh God, you have kept our homes. You have kept our lights on. Creator God, we thank you, oh God, that many of us have not gone hungry or homeless. Dear Lord, we thank you for this day. We thank you, oh God, for the many blessings, the many ways in which you have covered our lives, oh God, that which we have seen and that which is left unseen. Creator God, we ask that you bless the leaders of this congregation, that you bless the leaders of this movement, oh God. We ask, oh God, that you endow everyone that is called according to your purpose with extra gifts, oh God, extra gifts of grace and mercy, oh God, to get us through. Creator God, we thank you for that which you're going to do today in this service. We thank you, oh God, for the speaker of the hour that you have brought forth to us on today. Creator God, we thank you, oh God, for keeping our houses safe, our children safe, our partners and our spouses safe, oh God. We thank you, oh God, just because of who you are and the ways in which you continue to show up in our lives, oh God. Mercy unfiltered, mercy undeserved, oh God. And we thank you, Creator, for the blessed, the sacredness of life. Lord, we ask that you bless the remainder of this service, oh God, that you allow our hearts and minds to receive the word, oh God, that you have for them on today. We pray a special blessing over the leaders of this house, in our bishop-elect and our Reverend Janet Tucker. Creator God, endow them, oh God, with continued patience, because, Lord, this is not a work for the weak. Dear Lord, we ask that you just continue to cover them, their households, their finances, everything that their hearts desire to touch, and that their hands, oh God, is manifested to glorify in your name. Thank you, oh God, for all these blessings, and it's in your Son's name, Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen, ashe, and so it is.
Hallelujah.
Welcome.
Welcome.
I'm happy that everyone is here today. And I send love out to everyone. A little bit about our church. We are the Unity Fellowship Church of Columbia, which is an open and affirming congregation committed to a safe space where all can worship God in the fullness of who God is, just as we are. We share the liberating gospel of Christ in a loving, non-judgmental, welcoming, and God-centered way to all who can be reached by our work in fellowship, outreach, and service. Through focusing on the fundamental teachings of Jesus, the basic tenets of liberation theology, and through divine guidance, we provide opportunities for connection, reconnection, renewal, and restoration within the spiritual community. The Unity Fellowship Church of Columbia is one of 19 churches and fellowships across the nation and internationally that comprise the Unity Fellowship Church movement. To learn more about our movement, you can go to ufcmlife.org. Welcome. Now, a little bit about what we believe. God is love, and love is for everyone. No exceptions. It is impossible to love each other without a sense of mutual worth and respect for each other. Romans 13:10 reminds us, love worketh no ill to a neighbor. Therefore, love is the fulfilling of the law. 1 John 4:20 reminds us, it is impossible to love God whom we've never seen and hate our brothers and sisters whom we see every day. God is neither male nor female. God is spirit, and spirit has no gender. Liberation theology is for all and is not oppressive to anyone, regardless of gender, ethnicity, sexual orientation, faith practices, or previous religious affiliations. God is greater than any religion, denomination, or school of thought. Enlightenment and revelation are continuous. Who's writing the next chapter? And did not stop with those found in the Bible. Personal belief systems must be supportive of healthy self-acceptance, spiritual growth, and must encourage physical, emotional, and mental well-being. That's who we are. That's who we strive to be if we're not all the way there yet. But this is a place where you can grow, where you can become the person that God wants you to be. Not what your mother, your father, your sister, your brother, but what God wants you to be. What you believe that you should be doing. So grow and keep the faith and welcome. We will now have our affirmation by Deacon Renee Weaver, followed by our announcements by Reverend Janet Tucker.
Good morning again, family. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Today's affirmation is, I choose to see the light. And it comes from amihappy.com website. Are you happy?
I'm happy.
Okay, well, I'm happy too. I choose to see the light. I see in the world what I carry in my heart. And I choose to focus on the beauty, the love, and the positive. I have hope And so I can see that there is light despite all of the darkness. I am brave enough to explore the darkness that I might rediscover the power of my own light. Even in the middle of darkness, in fear's strongest efforts to sway me, I can still see the light shining still. Love will cast out all fear. And so my faith will remain tethered in love. You have been affirmed.
Amen. All right, good afternoon. Good afternoon. All right, we got a lot of announcements. There's a lot of things going on. Mark your calendars. One that's not in the bulletin, but I want to bring it to your attention. We have mid-year coming up.
Yes.
April 26th through 28th. It's a hybrid service. What does that mean for Unity Fellowship Columbia? That means we will be online.
All right.
So you will not have to travel to Towson. We will be in our Zoom room. We will broadcast the service coming from LA, Riverside. That's where it's coming from.
Amen. Okay?
So mark your calendars that particular Sunday. You do not have to join us here at 120 Allegheny, but you can join us in our Zoom room. If you need that information, you can send me an email, revjtucker868@gmail.com, and I'll give you the information. Convocation. Convocation is coming up October the 6th through the 13th. Registration is $160 for adults. Youth and young adults, $50. You do not have to have all the money at one time, but at least start your registration, put a deposit down to hold your space so that they know that you're coming. The idea is, you know, to try to get a handle on what the numbers are. I can tell you from working registration before, it's kind of good to know numbers in advance because you can plan based on what you know. So at least get registered and put a deposit down to hold your space. And if you're looking for flights and all that other type of stuff, you can see our Deacon Renee Weaver or myself, and we'll help you out from that aspect. If you're looking for Airbnb, I'm going to tell you, they're going fast.
Yes, they are.
Well, there's a lot of people out there who are looking for Airbnbs. Hotel, I think it's about booked. So a lot of people are coming. We have three bishops this year. Three bishops that are going to be elevated. Our very own Bishop-elect, Dorothy Parrish Harris. Our Bishop-elect, Kevin Taylor from Newark. And then our Bishop-elect, what's her first name?
Benita
Ramsey from California. So come on out. Come on out. And then locally, we have our very own Deacon Renee Weaver been elevated. So come on out. We got many, many reasons to be there. This year's convocation is all about inclusivity.
Yes.
It's open to anyone seeking personal and spiritual growth. So you don't have to be a member, but just come on and join and be with us and you know, start working on that physical and spiritual, personal growth, because it's so important that you grow and you become enriched in what you're trying to do, that there's somebody there to help you. And I'm quite sure that once you walk through those doors, you're going to feel fulfilled emotionally, physically, spiritually, and metaphysically. And this year, we also have our youth and young adults. They're going to be having their little institute at convocation, and it's all week long. All week long. So, you know, you can register your kids to come on and be out there with us. And I'm telling you, it's going to be a good time. It's not like any other you've ever been to before. So if you can't come Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, come Thursday, Friday, Saturday. I mean, come on out. This is going to be engaging and nurturing their spiritual growth as the next generation. Also, there's going to be a metaphysical workshop by Beatitude Jones. The right beatitude is personally facilitating this workshop on the subject of metaphysics, making it something that we can all understand. Because a lot of people will say, well, I don't think that way, but really you do. It's just a matter of understanding what it's all about to realize that you too think metaphysically. And as always, we're going to have health engagement activities. And so we have a bulletin that comes out monthly about the health and wellness around the movement. And so we're going to continue that during convocation to encourage physical and mental health, spiritual, emotional health. And I mean, it's going to be full force because they are preparing for us as we come out. So register for convocation, $164 adults, $50 for youth and young adults. We have our new book for our book club. It says April Book Club in your bulletin. On the screen, it says April Book Club. This is a book that we're going to be reading the month of April, and it may spill into May before we meet to discuss it. This book is called One of the Good Ones, and it's by Maika and Maritza Mulite. And I'm telling you, it is a good read. So come on, join us. We meet the book club. It'll be sometime on either Thursday night or Saturday. If it's Saturday, it's going to be about noon. You'll get more information about what day we're going to meet to discuss this particular book. Then after that, we have our Pride Month coming up. This year, we're expecting to take part in the parade and the events that they're going to have in the park on Sunday. And so we're looking for people to serve on the Pride Committee. Thinking about, you know, getting a booth and everything, but we need to know who wants to be there, who is going to be there, so that we can plan accordingly. We have been offered a car that we can use during the parade, so that, you know, those that may feel like, you know, not really up to it physically to be doing a lot of walking, I'm going to tell you from my experience, it's maybe about four blocks that the parade actually does, four or five blocks. And so it's not a long parade, but it's a parade to express what it is that we're trying to achieve. So please, please mark your calendars for June 15th and 16th. Those are the dates for the Baltimore Pride. And moving on down to the month of November 2nd, we're having a drag brunch, y'all. This is our second one. Second annual one. It's going to be a drag brunch with the atmosphere of worship. Tickets are on sale through Eventbrite. It is open. There is an opportunity. We have a limited amount of tickets that you can buy two for $80. So instead of paying $45 a ticket, you can buy two for $80, but they're limited. So I'm encouraging you to go get your tickets. We had an awesome time last year and an even better one we shall have this year. So get your tickets. It's on Eventbrite, Drag Brunch. As always, our weekly recorded prayers, they're up on YouTube. You can always go there anytime during the week. And if you need a little pick-me-up, it's there for you. Meditation Monday. Mondays at 6:30, join us in our Zoom room. We have meditation is guided, and it begins promptly now at 6:30, and we end promptly at 7 p.m. Tuesday evening, 7:30, we have spiritual development, and that's in our Zoom room as well. This week, we'll be discussing Luke 24, verse 36 through 48. Our instructor this week, Deacon Renee, you doing Bible study this week, right?
No.
Who's up?
Third week.
This is.
No, I'm away this week.
Okay, so you'll talk to me after service. All righty. Intercessory prayer team, Thursday morning, 6 a.m. You can join us on our Zoom room. Cameras do not have to be on, they can be off. And as always, flipgive.com, opportunities to give online. to give and to receive, I should add, because there are opportunities out there that even if you get something through, I'm going to just say Sam's Club, because I think now they're offering like a 2%. So you get something on Sam's Club, you too get something back. So it's just about any place you can think of shopping, but it also gives back to our church. And tithing, we'll be doing that later in service. You can start preparing now if you're giving electronically through paypal.me/UFC Columbia or through our Zelle at thecolumbiaproject09@gmail.com. We use our Gmail for our Zelle. If you have any media for our Sunday services, you should send them no later than Thursday to columbiaproductionteam@gmail.com. Any new announcements, they should go to announcements120@gmail.com. And I believe that's all our announcements. I'm making sure I didn't write myself any other notes. And that's it. Govern yourselves accordingly. And I look to see you at our upcoming events. We will have a psalm reading by Deacon Paulette Hall, followed by the Yaya moment.
Praise God, amen. Our psalm reading will be coming from Psalm number 4, chapter 4. Answer me when I call, God of my justice. Give me relief from my distress. Have mercy. Hear my prayer. How long will you people dishonor me before God? How long will you love delusion and pursue lies? Selah. Know that those who love Yahweh have been set apart by divine will. Yahweh will hear me when I call. Tremble and stop your sinning. Search your heart, alone and silent in your room. Offer sacrifices of justice and put your trust in Yahweh. So many are asking, does good even exist anymore? Let the light of your face, Yahweh, shine on us. You put joy in my heart, a joy greater than being full of bread and new wine. In peace I lie down. In peace I will sleep. For you alone, Yahweh, keep me perfectly safe. Bless God, amen. Amen.
If you look in your bulletin, there's a picture in there that says, "Let your light shine." Now, this moment is for the youth and the young at heart. Okay? And so I wrote a little something. God has equipped you with an internal light. This light is activated by believing in God, having faith, and believing in yourself. All three things. Once activated, you can show unconditional love and compassion. Your presence and smile. Can I get it? There you go. There you go. Can brighten someone else's day. You didn't say anything. You just was there, but your light is shining. Sometimes that's all it takes, right? You are the light of God here on earth. So let your light shine brightly every day. It's already there. Don't keep it to yourself. Shine.
Amen.
Just as bright as that picture in your bulletin.
Amen.
Thank
Amen.
You. Now our production team will give us a selection, followed by tithes and offering. Thank you.
Don't worry.
Everybody,
hold on.
Hold on.
You is coming. Hold on. Says you can make it.
Yes.
This is the part of service that everyone can participate in. It's tithes and offering time. Tithes and offering. If you're online, you can use paypal.me/UFC Columbia, or you can use Zelle. Zelle is the Columbia Project, 09@gmail.com. You can use any of those to give. If you're in-house, you can give cash, check, whatever it is that you have to give. And we have our usher, if you need an envelope, you can let her know. You can raise your hand and she'll bring you an envelope. We have a little saying, an affirmation, offer an affirmation that we do. And so I want everyone to join me at home too. You can have your little phone in your hand and you're gonna wave it. And so we say this together. This is my church, and my contribution, no matter how small, is very important in keeping this church that I love, we love, up and running. All right, up and running. Running to do things, running to keep the lights on, whatever it is, we're running. Doing it fast, doing it fast. And so we thank you for your contributions. They are a tremendous help to be able to help our church community, to be able to help the community in general. And so we thank you, thank you, thank you. Can't thank you enough for your generous giving. This time, are we finishing house? So we will lift this blessing up that has been given and say, Lord, thank you. Thank you for those that were able to give here digitally, however it was they were able to give, Lord. And we ask, Lord, that you would take it, God, and multiply it, that we may be able to continue to do more work than we have even thought that we could do. And so, God, we just say thank you. We thank you, those that are given. And we give you all honor, glory, and praise. In Jesus' name, amen, ashe, and so it is. And grab it.
Amen. We will have our Acts reading by Deacon Paulette Hall, followed by the sermonic, and then I will introduce our speaker.
Praise the Lord. Amen.
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 The New Testament reading of Acts will be coming from the third chapter, verses 12 through 19. Acts chapter 3, verses 12 through 19. When Peter saw this, he addressed the people as follows. Why does this surprise you? Why do you stare at us as if we had made this person walk by our own power or holiness? You are Israelites, and it is the God of Sarah and Abraham, Rebecca and Isaac, Leah and Rachel, and Jacob, the God of our ancestors, who has glorified Jesus, the same Jesus you handed over and then disowned in the presence of Pilate, after Pilate had decided to release him. You disowned the holy and just one and asked instead for the release of a murderer. You put to death the author of life, whom God raised from the dead, a fact to which we are witnesses. It is the name of Jesus and faith in it that has strengthened the limbs of this one whom you see and know well. Such faith has given this beggar perfect health, as all of you can see. Yet I know, my sisters and brothers, that you acted out of ignorance, just as your leaders did. God has brought to fulfillment by this means what was announced long ago by the prophets, that the Messiah would suffer. Therefore, reform your lives, turn to God, that your sins may be wiped away. Praise the Lord.
Come to me. God, I want to go with him when he comes back. I've come too far, and I never turn back. Oh,
God is the strength. Ah, y'all want me to talk after that? Okay, fine. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Woo! Glory. Ah, okay.
God is. God is.
God is. Okay. Reverend Brenda M. McCullough. That's a given name, married name, but most of all, that's my big sister. Hallelujah. And I'm really happy that she answered the yes. Reverend McCullough was ordained September the 29th, 2001, by the late Reverend Dr. Doris L. Gray, pastor of Straightway United Church of God and presiding Bishop Herbert H. Story. She is the retired pastor of Miracles of Faith Christian Center, which she opened with her husband, Minister Bavard McCullough, from August of 2009 through December of 2020. Reverend McCullough graduated with honors from Sojourner Douglas College in June of 2012 with a Bachelor of Arts degree in Human Growth and Development with a concentration in Psychology and Counseling. She also attended classes at Loyola College and the Pastoral Counseling Program. She has been married for 43 years, the mother of 5 children, and grandmother of 25 grandchildren.
Wow. Wow.
Reverend McCullough's favorite scripture is Isaiah 6:8. Also, I heard the voice of the Lord saying, whom shall I send? And who will go for us? Then I said, here I am, send me. Reverend.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord, everyone.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord, everyone. Hallelujah.
Yes.
So good. Hallelujah.
Yes, yes.
In the name of the Lord. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God is good.
Amen.
Oh, worthy to be praised.
Hallelujah. Yes.
Giving all honor to my Lord and Savior Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Bishop elect.
Bless you.
Assistant pastor.
Yes. Bless you. Amen.
All the officials. And my brothers and sisters, it's an honor to be here today.
Yes.
I've had a good time so far. It's not my first time being here, but I did always tell Pastor and my sister, every time I walk in here, it feels good.
Yes.
You understand what I'm saying? Feels like you're coming into the presence of the Lord.
Yes.
It feels like you're walking into a cloud.
My God, my God. Yes, yes.
And I can't say that about everywhere. That
yes, right. Into. Yes.
You understand what I mean? You walk in some places and you commit, you start to pray. You got to pray. You're away from the door to your seat and just keep praying. But in here, and I thank God. That's good. Where do I start? I was asked to preach, and I was given certain scriptures and all by my sister, who I must say, she's a blessing. She's thorough.
Yes, she is.
The Lord got me together. It took all week, but she got me together, and I'm here. I love her dearly. See what I mean? I love that your theme for this month, is that what it is? The power of resurrection.
Amen. Yes, yes, yes.
Well, I love this time of the year. It means so much to me. To me, and a lot of people recognize his birth, but it's, and I recognize that too, but it's the death and resurrection.
Yes.
It's the fulfillment. You know, it's they, how they treated my Lord. Mm-hmm. And I try not to do much on Fridays. Mm-hmm. If you notice, it's sort of dark and dreary on Good Friday.
Mm-hmm.
It mostly rains on Good Friday, mm-hmm. You know. And then Resurrection Sunday, it gives us hope. New things come up.
Amen.
It happens in the springtime, where the flowers are coming back and the yes. birds are carrying on and grass is getting greener. It's new birth. It's newness. And I praise God for all that he's done for me. I take it personal for all that he's done for me.
Yes.
I praise God for this time. Yes. It makes me remember him even the more. And enjoy who he is in my life. Because right now, I don't know about you, but I got a lot going on in my life.
Yeah. Yeah.
I don't know about y'all, but
no, that's right.
All hell is broke loose in my life.
Yes.
I need him, and I know he's there.
Yes.
So I'm going to pray, go on with where he leads me.
Amen.
Amen. I get long-winded, come on.
Uh-huh.
All right? It's okay.
Okay.
Amen. Dear Lord, Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord God, we thank you for this day and this time. Lord God, I thank you for all who have, Lord, and not robbery, just to come and gather together so we can learn more about you and worship you, Lord God, in our own ways, Lord God. We come here for different reasons, Lord God, then you know each and every reason, Lord God. I ask you to bless everybody sitting here, Lord God. Lord God, as I go forward, Lord God, let the words that come out of my mouth be what you want me to say. Just move this silly little girl on back and use me however you want. And I'll always remember to give you all the praise, the honor, and the glory. In Jesus' name, amen. So I chose Luke 24:36-48. To be what I'm going to preach about, to be my sermon. And I'm going to read that for you. Amen?
Amen.
All right. And this is from the Amplified Version. While they were talking about this, Jesus himself suddenly stood among them and said to them, "Peace be to you." But they were startled and terrified and thought that they were seeing a spirit. And he said, "Why are you troubled? And why are doubts rising in your hearts? Look at the marks in my hands and my feet and see that it is I myself. Touch me and see. A spirit does not have flesh and bones as you see that I have." After saying this, he showed them his hands and his feet. And while they still did not believe it because of their joy and amazement, he asked, "Do you have anything here to eat?" I love it. They gave him a piece of broiled fish, and he took it and ate it in front of them. Then he said to them, "This is what I told you while I was still with you, everything which has been written about me in the law of Moses and the writings of the prophets and the Psalms must be fulfilled." Then he opened their minds to help them. Say, "Open my mind."
Open my
yes.
Mind.
Say it again. Open my mind.
Open my mind.
Woo, say it one more time. Open my mind.
Open my mind.
Woo, Jesus. Then he opened their minds to help them understand the scriptures and said, "And so it is written that the Christ, the Messiah, the anointed, would suffer and rise from the dead on the third day, and that repentance necessary for forgiveness of sins would be preached in his name to all the nations, beginning from Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things." Amen.
Amen.
That's a lot. That's a lot. This was a very, for those who knew him, this was a very crazy kind of time.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Those closest to them didn't know if he was coming or going.
Mm-hmm.
They had found out that he was no longer in the tomb.
Yeah.
And some didn't believe when the women came to tell me one of the disciples ran to the tomb to see for himself.
That's right.
And it was the so-called talk of the town. Mm-hmm. Could you imagine if you were there? My Lord. And so it happened like 3 times. If I had to give this a title, I would put Knowing Jesus.
Mm-hmm. Knowing
Jesus. And no matter what form he is.
That's good.
Yeah.
That's
good. Do you know him? Mm-hmm. You got to believe in him. Yes. You got to know something about him in order to know him. You gotta have known him for a little while. You must have had some kind of encounter with him to know him. And then, would you know him if you saw him? He appeared to these particular people 3 times.
That's right.
3 times. Mm-hmm. In different ways.
That's right.
In verse 24:13, they didn't recognize him. 13 through 16, they didn't recognize him.
That's right.
Maybe because he might have been his glorified body. We don't know. Mm-hmm. You know, they don't have the privilege of studying him and knowing the Bible, and we know why. You understand? But they were frustrated. They were upset. Their Savior had been crucified. And then now, where is he?
Yeah.
Huh? And then, besides not recognizing him back there in 24:13 through 16, got a little sarcastic with them in verse 18.
That's right.
How dare they? What do you mean? Don't you know what's going on around here? That's paraphrasing what it said in my
head.
Huh? Got a little sarcastic with my Lord. What? Huh? And then again in 24:31, just not recognizing. You have to know this man for yourself. Mm-hmm. How do you recognize him?
Mm.
How do you see him?
Yeah.
How do you feel him?
Yeah.
The song that was played, God Is, means a lot to me because all of that is how I feel. Mm-hmm. And I saw you enjoying it, so it's how you feel too. It takes us in different ways in our lives to see that he was always there.
Right.
No matter what it was that we were going through, that he was there the whole time.
The whole time.
Even when we're saying, God, where are you?
Yes.
Where you at? Why you let this happen to me? How could this happen to me? He was there. Things happen for a reason. I have a plan for you, he says. A plan to prosper you and not hurt you. But then there's always darts coming at you. But if we stay on the narrow way, huh? They couldn't get us. Sometimes we go off the narrow way. But we still, if you know him and you've given your life to him, we're still supposed to be on that plan.
Yes, yes.
I want to give you a little bit of my testimony. And you'll see what I mean. Back in September of 2020. My sister knows where I'm going. I was asked to perform a renewal of vow for a couple that I had married like 10 years previous. And it was far away. At the time I was living in Rosedale, they live in Leonardtown, Maryland, 2 hours and more away. I never drive that far by myself. Always someone wants to go with me. My husband couldn't go because he wasn't feeling well. And I'm like, but you helped me marry him. Come on. You know, I mean, no, I wouldn't anyway. But anyway, he couldn't go. So on my way, I said, well, I gotta go. I promised them. I love this young couple. They've come so far. I just love them dearly. I said, I gotta go. But on my way, I stopped at my daughter's house. It was like 10 minutes away from me. And she had just had one of my grandsons, a new baby. And my oldest son was there, and they were playing with the baby and everything. And I wanted to see if she wanted to go. If anybody didn't want to go because of different and various reasons, she just didn't want to leave that cute baby. Nobody wanted to go. So the only one that said, I'll go with you, Grandma, was my granddaughter. But I said, no, maybe not, because I figured she'd be bored with the ride and everything. So I said, I'll just go. Went there. The renewal of the vows was awesome. It was great. And it was time for me to leave. They load me up with all these plates of good food and stuff, put it in my car, and I'm on my way. And I text my daughter and my husband, said, I'm on my way back. They made me promise to let them know because it was such a long ride. I'm on my way back. I wasn't 5 minutes from their house, and I was sitting at a light. And it was a turn light. Now, I know I'm not familiar with the area or anything, but there was no red light. No, I saw a turn. So I went to make a left. And it dawned on me as I was making this left, that this left was a long time. It was like I was going down this long road. And I couldn't figure out what was going on. I had been hit. I had been broadside, but I didn't know at the time. Now, I just want you to find God in this. It was a terrible accident. I blacked out. That's why I thought I was still moving in my mind. As you say, in my mind, I was still going, but I wasn't. I came to just enough to hear somebody say, it was the medics, I'm sure, don't worry, miss, you're going to be all right. We're getting you out of the car. And I thought I heard my husband's voice in my car. Wasn't sure. Blacked out again. You see God in this? When I came to, I was in the emergency room. And the emergency attendant said, the nurse said, is it okay if I cut this pretty dress? Because we got to examine you or whatever. And I'm like, cut it. I came to. Now, this is during COVID time. Nobody could come in. Nobody could see me. Nobody knew what was going on. I didn't even know what was going on because I blacked out again. God kept blacking. I woke up again, and the attendant said, the nurse said, your daughter's here, but she can't come in. But she wants to know if you're okay. Can we call her on your phone? Or something like that. I can't even remember, but I do remember telling her I'm okay and I wasn't okay. And I talked to her. Well, they stayed until I got out. I think I was in the hospital 3 days. But let me tell you about God. In and out, I remember the only thing that hurt me is when they moved me, they had to do all these x-rays. They kept x-raying me, kept x-raying, put me in my room, take me out, x-ray, x-ray. When I had a chance to talk and was cognizant enough, I found out that the car that I was in was a horrific mess. My husband and my son-in-law said they went to view the car and get stuff out of it, said that my seat was over by the other seat like it was a love seat. Windows cracked, crushed up, it was a mess, to the point where they said the attendant of the tow yard asked, I don't mean no harm or no disrespect, but did the person die? And they said, no, she's alive.
Thank the Lord.
You see God, are you seeing God in this? Said she's alive. Alive. Now, mind you, they couldn't see me. They didn't know what I looked like. I'm just figuring out what had happened. And when they told me what the car looked like, and I hung up the phone, and I looked at myself. I looked at myself. Mm-hmm. I didn't have a scratch.
Praise the Lord.
I had not a scratch. I didn't have no blood. They said the glass was broken. I had no scratches or anything. Nothing. But I did have a fractured pelvis. That's what was hurting me. So the doctor, when he came in, he says, I have good news, bad news, and good news. He said, the bad news is you have a fractured pelvis. The good news is it's going to heal itself. You do not need surgery.
Amen.
I finished. When I was amazed, and I knew it was God, and I cried. I cried when I realized how that car looked and how I looked and how I was. But he said this, but I think I saw something on that left kidney. When you go back to your doctor, have him check it. So I said, okay. So I finally got out and got home. Whole family there, they picked me up to carry me in. And I finally went to the doctor, I'll make this short. And he says, I think you might have cancer. I had cancer. It had metastasized. Am I saying that right? Where it was in some of my bones, in my back, and my hip. It was in my hip so bad that I had to have a hip replacement. If not, the tumor from the cancer was going to fracture it. Mm. I had no idea. If I hadn't had the accident, if I hadn't had the accident, I'd have never known. And let's go back a little bit further, because I kept thinking about this, and like, I praise you, God. And it took a few times for them to get all of it together to tell me what was going on inside of me. That's why nobody could go. That's why nobody could go with me. This was a planned accident. That's the only thing I could say. Huh? He knew this was his way of telling his little girl, girl, something going on with you. Can you keep still, please, and so we can get this taken care of? Nobody was supposed to go with me. Nobody was supposed to be with me. I healed. I walk with a little bit of limp because I got a new knee and a new hip. You know what I'm saying? I'm bionic on this guy. But this is how I think my relationship is with him. I love him. He knows I love him. Huh? And I saw him in this. I know he was with me. I know he orchestrated it. I know he was with me through this whole thing. That's why I didn't have no cuts and I didn't have no bruises. And I just had a fractured pelvis, which did hurt, but it healed. And I'm still here. Still here. I'm still here. Nobody but God. Nobody but God. But we got to see him. We got to know. We got to recognize, as they say, who we belong to. He has a plan for me. He wasn't done with me yet. My sister and assistant pastor tell me all the time, you ain't going nowhere. He's not finished with you yet. He's not done with you. Because I'm just going to sit down. Is it people? You know what I'm saying. Huh? Go to church here and there. Shut mine down because it was time. But I put them under my best friend's church. Of them, you know, but I just want you to know that he's real.
Amen.
He's alive, willing, and waiting.
Yes.
for you to give him everything you got so he can give you everything he's got. There's nothing too hard for my God.
That's right. Yes.
You can't tell me he's not thinking about you. He's thinking about you all the time, because if the word of God said he's got a plan for you, you got to carry out until that plan is done. It just wasn't my time. My car was totaled. They could barely get it open to get my stuff. I'm like, I need my Bible. I need this. I wish I could have had them places. But anyway, you know what I'm saying. He cared about me.
Yes.
If this had gone on, I wouldn't be alive now.
Yes. Yes.
I had had it so long that it was really, really bad on this side. I didn't know. I didn't feel anything. I didn't hurt. I was just going on about my merry way. But that's the kind of God I serve.
Yes.
That's the kind of God he is.
Yes.
He can appear to you any kind of way he wants to.
Absolutely.
You better recognize and know when he's appearing to you. Huh? You better recognize and know when he's trying to get your attention. You better recognize and know when he's tapping you. Huh? Come on now. He needs you beyond catastrophic events. Each and every one of us has something to do for the kingdom. Each and every one of us has a job to do.
Yes.
If you know more than pray for people, think about people, call somebody up that you know by themselves and talk to them, make their day, give them some company, whatever it is. In fact, you need to just say, okay, God, what is it you want me to do? And then when he makes it clear to you, whether you like it or not, whether you think it fits you or not, you better go ahead and do it. We are all that we got. We are all that we can depend on. Huh? I should maybe pick up the phone and call any of y'all and say, this Pastor Brenda, can you pray for me, please?
Yes. Amen.
And it's okay.
That's right.
Know him. Don't let him be walking with you and you don't even know. One of these, he was sitting down at the table eating, and they didn't know until he went back and looked like the Last Supper. And they said, oh, that's you, Jesus. Come on now.
All right.
Come on now.
Amen.
You did it. Don't be like that. Amen. Know who he is in your life.
Yes, yes.
Talk to him. Pray to him. I talk to him like I'm talking right now. I do. I got a lot going on in my life, and I can't stop talking to him.
Because
I need him to make me understand what is going on. What is going on? Okay, where do I fit in here? Do I pray? Sometimes we don't have to do nothing. Sometimes we're supposed to stand back.
That's right. Stay still. Stay still.
What? Keep your hands to yourself.
That's right.
Keep your mouth to yourself. Just stand back and watch him.
That's right.
Oh. Watch him fix it. Watch him do it. And another thing, we can't rush him either.
That's right. That's right.
You put your petition out there and then you wait.
Wait.
Okay. We'll have a glass of lemonade.
Right.
Sit down somewhere in the sun.
Wait. Wait.
I'm just real. I'll be real. But I love the Lord.
Yes.
I know he's real.
Yes.
I know he's true.
Yes.
I know he's there for each and every one of us. Don't let a minute go by that you don't think of him at least once. Because you are a being because of him.
Yes.
You exist
because
of him.
Yes.
And we have to give him all the honor and the glory. Tell him you love him. I don't care how upset you are. In the worst situation, say, okay, God, you know I love you now. What's up? I need you to tell him, make it clear to you.
That's right.
Amen.
Yes.
He's your father. You can talk to your father. You can be real with him because you already know. He just wants you to come to him. He just wants you to know if you recognize who he is in your life. So I say, knowing Jesus, Would you know him if you saw him? Would you know him in every situation? Amen.
Amen.
God bless you.
Amen.
Do you know? Do you know? Do you know? Do you know? Do you know that you know? That's what's important. Knowing Jesus.
Knowing Jesus.
Knowing Jesus. Sometimes we spend so much time trying to know everybody else.
All right.
But we don't even know the one that gives us life, wakes us up every day. Allows us to walk, talk, and do all those things that we do do.
Yeah.
But we want to know them. We don't want to know the one, the only, the important one. Do you know Jesus? Awesome word, Pastor.
Yeah.
Awesome word, awesome word. Yeah. Thank you for finally saying yes. I've been trying to get her up here probably for about 6 months now. She said, Reb, I'm retired. I said, retired from what? You never retired from the word. You never retired. I said, but I'll wait. I'll wait. And then it came. Awesome word. It's that time of the service now where we open the doors of the church, online, here in a place that there's a person that's looking for a home, church home. This is the place. You feel the same, let us know. You're too shy, you can call 443-400-7214. Leave a message, send a text. Say, I'm shy, but I'm interested. And we'll get back to you. Because we believe in God is love and love is for everyone. So if you haven't had love, come on, get some.
Yes.
Because we're here to give it to you. Come on down. All right. So we're going to move from there to prayer. This is part of our service. We open up. You want to step in the gap for someone. Lift their name up, or a situation. It could be a situation. You speak it, and we acknowledge each one with a shay, and then we pray. And so I'm going to start out by saying, my family.
Brenda Wright.
Ashe.
Andre Weaver.
Ashe. 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 Ashe, 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 Ashe. All righty, I'm going to say leadership. And that's a big group of people. But I'm going to say leadership. Dear Lord, we thank you for this day, Lord. We thank you for this opportunity to come and to learn, Lord, to come and to become wiser, God. Knowing, God, that it is not by chance that that word came, God. But God, in being resurrected, sometimes it takes those things that happen to us, God, that get us to see, God, that you are there, that you are trying to speak to us. And so, God, we say thank you. Thank you, God, for knowing us. And God, we ask that even as you know us, God, may you allow us to open up that we may know you more. That we may have a little closer walk
with thee. And so, God, you've heard all the names that were petitioned, the situations. And we know, God, that you know what it is that they need. And so we ask, God, that as always, that you shall supply their every need. That you may allow them to know that you are here. That you are the great I am. That you are the one, God, that opens doors that we don't even see, God. We see it as a wall and you open it up as a door. And so, God, we just say thank you. God, we thank you for those that may not have been able to make it to the building today, God. But, God, we know that you have a plan for them, God. And so, God, we thank you for the plan, God. We thank you that we were even able to open the doors, God, for those that may have wanted to come in. And God, if they thought a little shaky about the situation, God, we ask, God, that you turn it around, that they may be able to get what it is they need, God. And so, God, we thank you for choosing us as a place, God, that people can come and feel the love, God. Feel your love, God, that shines through each one of us, God. And so, God, we ask that even as we continue to minister to this community, God, that you allow us to see opportunities so that we can walk in them, God, taking you with us to be able to manifest those things, God, that you want to manifest. And so, God, we say thank you. God, you're wonderful, you're powerful, and you're awesome. And so, God, we ask that you would just allow us, God, to continue to exude that within us, that people can see you in us as we walk through our daily comings and goings, and we talk to those that we come across. May they know that you are still here. That it's not a figment of their imagination, but that you are here. And so, Lord, we thank you for being here. And we give you all honor, glory, and praise. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Ashe. And so it is.
And all that is within me, bless God's holy name. Bless the Lord. Thank you, God. Thank you, God, for Pastor Brenda McCullough. Thank you for that word, that message, reminding us that God is with us all the time. Encouraging us to see God in the many ways that God shows up. Remember last week, as we closed, I said, do some God spotting this week. And Pastor Brenda came right in and reminded us of the God spotting that we can do on a daily basis.
Yes.
How we can look around and say, that was God. Oh, that was God. Oh, otherwise,
absolutely.
As she said, Jesus will show up. God will show up. And you don't even recognize God. The disciples followed Jesus. They knew Jesus intimately, hung out with Jesus,
amen,
and still didn't recognize him. How much more should we be on alert sometimes?
Yes, yes.
Those times when we're worried and upset and wondering where God is, and God can say to us, here I am.
Yes.
Let's continue. Let's continue to ask God to open our eyes, open our minds,
yes,
so we may see God in a bigger way, in a clearer way, every day. Amen. Amen. Thank you again, Pastor McCullough. Thank you for gracing us with that wonderful word. We honor God for you, for your ministry. For your little sister, And for all the ways that you blessed us today through the word of God. Thank you, family, for being here. Those of you who are online, thank you for joining us today. I thank God for you and for the God in you. Not only do I want you to do more God spotting this week, but I want you to start seeing God in others. That person that gets on your nerves. That person that's difficult to reach. That person that's calling out for help. The person that you may see on the side of the road. Start seeing God in them. And acknowledge that God in them. Amen. And you will then see more and more God in them. Bless the Lord, family. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Let us stand for the benediction. What a wonderful, wonderful, blessed day and blessed service. Thank you, everyone, for your participation in making this the great service that it is today. God, we just love you. We bless you. We honor you. Thank you for this worship service today. We thank you for your presence in this worship experience. Thank you for the speaker of the hour and for the ways in which you've shown up through her as her. And we thank you for that. Bless us, oh Lord, as we go out of these doors. Remind us that you have never left us and you've never forsaken us, that you are with us each and every day, all day, Lord God. Bless us this week. That the words that were spoken, that the songs that were sung, that the scriptures that were read will show up for us at just the right time, reminding us of your presence, reminding us of your omnipresent love, spirit, peace, and help us to draw on that each day, Lord God. And we bless you, and we thank you, and we honor you. Give us traveling mercies as we go to our respective places. Let us always remember that you are love, that love is for everyone. Now unto the one who is able to keep us from falling, who will present us faultless before the presence of God with exceeding joy, to the wise God, our Savior, be glory and majesty, dominion and power, both now and forever. Let us sing amen together. Amen, amen, amen. You sound so beautiful. Have a blessed week.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
How long that take? Did you look and see how long?
Thank you.
Small world.
And she went to the world.
Yeah. And she's got ready to, she was with a company but
special.
Mm-hmm.
I think she